Thank you. Senate will come to order. I ask all present to please rise and join with me as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Today's invocation will be offered by the Reverend Peter G. Young of the Mother Teresa community here in Albany.
Thank you, Senator.
Let us pray. God never fails to provide our New York State citizens with dedicated leadership and senators. May God pour forth his blessings on our legislators and provide them with the spirit of courage to accept the many demands of their elected offices. As senators, they report on this day to the session bill, to the bell that will again call them to hear one another for the benefit of our New York State constituents. This invocation calls us to be true, to be the best at what we might be able to become as a legislative leader. We need to heed the call of our own hearts with compassion and with equity. May God bless this assembly.
Thank you, Father Young. Reading of the journal.
In Senate Tuesday, March 4th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Monday, March 3rd, is read and approved on motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal will stand approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions, Senator LaValle.
Mr. President, I believe there is a previously adopted resolution by Senator Montgomery, Resolution 3334, at the desk, and I ask to have the title read and call on Senator Montgomery.
And the Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution Number 3334 by Senator Montgomery, commending Gail Stevens Haynes, Esquire, upon the occasion of being honored in conjunction with Women's History Month 2014 in the state of New York.
Senator Montgomery.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise again today to honor another woman during this Women's History Month. She is a woman who is the provost of one of the major higher educational institutions in our state that happens to be in my district. That is Long Island University. Gail Stevens Haynes is the Vice President, Chief Operating Officer, and Legal Counsel of Long Island University. And she is the Long Island University Brooklyn Campus Provost. I have been able to have a relationship with Provost Gail Haynes for some years, and I have watched as she has made that campus, the university, Long Island University campus, a very, very major player as it relates to higher education, especially for adults, but as well for young adults. There are a number of certificate programs. There are a number of arts programs. The university itself, the campus itself, has become in and of itself a wonderful example of what a university campus in the urban setting could look like. It has wonderful artwork and buildings, and it is teeming with activity at all times. So this all has happened over the past 10 to 15 to 20 years since Provost Gail Stevens has been there, really leading that university to be a very major institution in our state, and I am very, very proud of the work that she has done. So today I can stand here very, very proudly to say that not only is Provost Stevens a friend, but she is one of those phenomenal women who has steered a very major institution into this century so that it serves so many hundreds of thousands of people in the borough of Brooklyn and across the city. So today we are honoring Gail Stevens Haynes, the provost of the Long Island University Brooklyn campus. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Montgomery. As indicated, this resolution was adopted on February 4th of 2014. Senator Lavelle.
Mr. President, may we please have the non-controversial reading of the calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 130 by Senator Martin, Senate Print 988A, an act to amend the penal law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Klein, Libous, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Relation to calendar 130, those recorded in the negative are Senators DeLon and Montgomery. Ayes 53, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 131 by Senator Roback. Senate print 1016, an act to amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Klein, Libous, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Montgomery.
Ayes 54, nays 1. Senator Montgomery recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 133 by Senator Grisanti, Senate Print 1590, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Klein, Libous, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Senator Grisanti to explain his vote.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. My fellow colleagues, this is a piece of legislation that we've passed the last few years, and it's named after in honor of Amanda Lewinkowski, who died tragically in 2008. In Buffalo. And what this legislation is quite simply this. Right now, there are no laws on the books that deal with concealing or hiding of a dead body. Amanda Wynkowski was found naked in a garbage can in Buffalo. She did not get there by herself. Somebody moved that body from one scene to another, thereby disturbing possible investigation and possible leads into not only the cause of her death, but who may have caused her death, who may have been a part of it. The only legislation that is on the books at the present time only has to do with, you know, directors, medical professionals, and cemeteries on how to dispose of human bodies at only misdemeanor levels. This piece of legislation, time and time again, passes this House. We need to get the Assembly on board with this legislation to get it passed, because under current law, a person can hide a body from authorities and disturb a crime scene without any real punishment whatsoever. I urge all my colleagues in this House to vote for it and urge your Assembly members that something needs to be done, because this law, as I said, does not exist, and tragedy strikes and you have somebody that died and really they don't know the reason why or who may have been a part of it. I vote aye.
Senator Grisanti to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 54, nays 1. Senator Montgomery recorded the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 135 by Senator Young, Senate Print 2205, an act to amend the criminal procedure law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Klein, Libous, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Senator Gibson to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to commend the sponsor for taking a big step forward in helping our victims of domestic violence. Domestic violence is a real crisis here in our state. There are more and more victims than we've ever had that are suffering from a variety of different horrible crimes in the realm of domestic violence. This bill will help those witnesses who are vulnerable testify against those who have committed the crimes against them. There are many, many more things that we should continue to do to help our victims of domestic violence. For instance, there are specially trained dogs that are trained to help witnesses in the witness stand. I have a bill called Rosie's Law that does exactly that, and I would encourage my colleagues to take a look at that. I will be voting yes for this piece of legislation. Thank you.
Senator Gibson to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes 57.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 136 by Senator Klein, Senate Print 2322, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Klein, Libous, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin.
Perkins, Montgomery.
Ayes 55, nays 2. Senators Montgomery and Perkins record the negative.
The bill is passed. Senator Lavelle, that completes the reading of the non-controversial calendar.
Thank you, Mr. President. Is there any other business at the desk?
There is no further business before the desk.
There being no further business, I move we adjourn until Thursday, March the 6th at 11 a.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Thursday, March 6th at 11 a.m. Senate adjourned.